come on, thank God for our young people. Amen. Thank God for all of our young people, and we want to thank God for the parents who bring your children. Thank you for bringing your children that we might be a part of teaching them the things of Jesus Christ. Amen. Again, we want to thank God for Sister Kim Gilliam. Amen. Thank God for Sister Kim. And the men are coming to the parsonage after service. We're going to watch the game today. Amen. The men are invited to come to the parsonage to watch the game. Amen. Whether you're a football lover or not, if you're a man, come on and hang out with some other men. Amen. Amen. Your wife will let you come. Amen. She'll let you go. She don't have watch football anyway. So come on, watch football with some men. Amen. 1029 Peachtree Road. Come on, we want to watch the Panthers and the Seahawks today. Amen. If you turn your Bibles to the Gospel of St. Mark, the 10th chapter, and we want to use verse 48 as our text. The Gospel of St. Mark 10 and 48. We honor the Lord today. We thank God for Jesus, his shed blood on the cross, his blood that washes and cleanses us from all of our sins. We are so glad that Jesus went to an old rugged cross. He hung, bled, and died that we might have the right to the tree of life. Didn't have to do it, but he did. Died on the cross. The Bible says he could have called legions of angels that would have come and rescued him, but when he thought about you and I, he would not come down, but he decided to die just to save us. And I don't know about you, I'm so glad that he did. I'm glad that he died on that cross. They put him in a borrowed tomb, but early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. And because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone, because I know who holds my future. Life is worth the living just because he lives. Got up from the grave and went back to his Father, and one day he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. We'll be caught up to meet him in the air, and so shall we forever be with the Lord. Isn't that good news? Isn't that good news? We thank God for good news today. Amen. To all of the preachers who are assembled, God bless you today. And to Presiding Elder Moore and to Sister Moore, God bless you. Mother Williams is not here, but we're happy to report that she is home now. Amen. She's home. And we thank the Lord for raising her up, sending her back home. But to Mother Williams in her absence, to Mother Bird, God bless you, and to the First Lady of this church, Reverend Gloria Redden, in her absence. Amen. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come, and God, we thank you for another opportunity to lift up your word. We pray, God, that you would bless, save, heal, deliver today in the name of Jesus, encourage somebody's heart, and we thank you for your word. Now, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. St. Mark 10 and 48. And many charged him that he should hold his peace, but he cried the more a great deal, "Thou son of David, have mercy on me." I want to preach from the topic today, if at first you don't succeed, try, try, try again. Turn and tell your neighbor that if first you don't succeed, try, try, try again. Turn and tell somebody else, if at first you don't succeed, try, try, try again. Amen. For the last few weeks in Bible study, that's every Wednesday at 12 noon and 7 o'clock p.m. In Bible study, we've been looking at and we've been studying the subject of prayer. In the Gospel of St. Luke, the 11th chapter, we read where the disciples ask Jesus to teach them how to pray. Jesus, the Bible says, then gave them the prayer that is found in the Gospel of St. Matthew and Luke. And we know that prayer to be the Lord's Prayer. Now, the Lord's Prayer is a model prayer. Jesus gave it to us and to them to teach us how to pray. And the genius of this prayer is that it gives us guidelines. It gives us outlines to the parts of prayer. There are so many of us who often say we don't know how to pray, and maybe it's just that we are afraid to pray in public. But there is a way that you can just learn how to pray from the Lord's Prayer, because in the Lord's Prayer, we see the parts of prayer. It gives us the correct way to approach God. You know, how many know that you can't approach God any old kind of way? You should not approach God like he's just your ace boon coon, that he's your cut buddy. There's a way that we ought to approach a true and living God. It is a way that we ought to address God. It teaches us first that only God should be the object of our prayer. We should not pray to people, persons, and things. We should not pray to dead folk. They're dead and gone, and they can't answer your prayer. But how many know that you don't have to pray to somebody who's dead, because your God is yet still alive? It teaches us that God only is to be prayed to. Remember Elijah. Remember the prophet Elijah and contest that was on Mount Carmel with the prophets of Baal. You remember that Elijah got the people of Israel together, and he said to them, "How long will you halt between two opinions? If Baal be God, follow him. But if God be God, follow him." And we know that the prophets of Baal prayed all morning and afternoon long, and nobody answered their prayer. But when Elijah prayed to his God, how many know that God sent down fire, that God answered Elijah by fire, thereby proving that he was the one living, only a living God? And I want you to understand that the way that we ought to approach God, the Bible teaches us in this Lord's Prayer, is that we should adore God. And I don't mind telling you today that I adore my God. Anybody else in here today adore God? You just adore God. And how many know that we adore God because when we look back over our lives and when we see how far God has brought us, we can just adore God. Anybody here know that God saved you from yourself? That when you were on your way to hell and when you were making hell out of your own life, aren't you glad that God saved you even from yourself? I adore God. I adore God because God is God all by himself. And beside God, there is no other. But I also adore God because he first loved me. I didn't even love him first. He loved me first. Anybody glad that he loved you first? He looked beyond all of your faults and he saw our every need. I adore him because one day he picked me up, turned me around, placed my feet on solid ground. Anybody glad about that today? That it was nobody but God that turned your life around. I adore him because he has extended to me. He has shown me his grace, his mercy, his goodness, and his favor. That's why I adore God, because every time I think about how good God has been to me, I've got to open up my mouth and I've got to tell my God, I just want to thank you for all you've done for me. Why don't you tap your neighbor and say, neighbor, we're just here to praise and magnify our God, because God has been good to us. Yesterday he was good to us. He's good to us today. And how many know that he's going to be good to us even tomorrow? Give your neighbor a high five and say, neighbor, the God we serve is a good God, and he is worthy to be praised. We just come to magnify and adore our God. Listen to the psalmist in Psalm number 8, when the psalm writer says, oh Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Who has set thy glory above the heavens? Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heavens and the works of thy fingers, the moon and stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yea, the beasts of the field and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passeth through the paths of the sea. O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Can you say that with me? Oh, come on, y'all. O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. How many know that God is an excellent God? His goodness is excellent. His mercy is excellent. How many know that him being your provider, he's an excellent provider. He's an excellent healer today. How many know that God's joy is excellent? How many know that God's peace is excellent? Everything about God is excellent. Oh, come on, tap your neighbor, tell your neighbor, I just adore my God. He tells us in the Lord's Prayer that not only should we adore him, but we should ask God to give us our daily bread. Notice it doesn't tell us to ask God for what's going to happen tomorrow, but it talks about asking God to give us our daily daily bread. Because how many know that you're worrying about tomorrow when in reality you don't even know if you're going to live till tomorrow? So why are you worrying about something that might not even happen anyway? But how many know that God is your provider? How many know that it's God who puts food on your table and clothes on your back? Can I get a witness here? How many know that God is able to supply all of your needs? Then there's the request that God would help us and give us power over a temptation and the evil one, the devil, who brings the temptation. Always know that as long as you live, you're going to be tempted by something and tempted by someone. But how many know that you can be tempted, but you don't have to fail the temptation? God put something inside of us. Though the temptation might come, you have power on the inside of you that gives you power over a temptation. Oh, Lord, help me today. When I think about the devil, and when I think about all that the devil tries to do to us, and when I think about all that the devil has done to us, the thing that we can remember today and praise God for today is that with all that he tried to do, we are still here. And not only are we still here, we got nerve enough to come into the house of the Lord and lift up our hands and open up our mouths and tell God, thank you. Though it was bad, it could have been worse. And I'm thanking God that what happened to me did not kill me, but now I'm just a little bit stronger because God gave me power to overcome it. Oh, come on, give your neighbor a high five and say, neighbor, I'm glad you're here today, because if the devil would have had his way, he would have killed you a long time ago. He would have destroyed you a long time ago. But how many know that God gave you power to overcome? And so my Bible tells me that greater, Lord help, greater is he that's within me than he that's in the world. Oh, the devil may huff and he may puff and try to blow this house down. But what the devil has to realize is this house is built on the rock. And that rock is Jesus Christ. And as long as I've got Jesus in my life, on my side, I've got a feeling that everything's gonna be all right. Come on, tap your neighbor and tell him everything's gonna be all right. You don't have to yield to temptation. And understand today that the devil does nothing but sell a bunch of wolf tickets. He'll tell you all that's going to happen to you. He'll tell you what you think the worst is going to happen to you. But you can't listen to the devil. You've got to listen to God. And if God says you're going to be all right, you are going to be all right. If God says he'll lift you above it, then God has the power to lift you above it. If God says I'm going to bless you, you can take it to the bank. Because if God says he's going to bless you, hang in there and hold on. power to bless your life. How many know that God is in the blessing business? And if you came here today looking for a blessing from God, I came to tell you, you're in the right place at the right time. Oh, the devil, he should have kept you in bed today. But when God woke you up and you had your mind stayed on Jesus and you got up, took your shower, got your clothes together, got in your car, came to church, I come to tell you right here, right now, there's a blessing with your name on it. Come on, shake somebody's hand like you're going to shake it off and say, neighbor, I just feel like blessings are coming my way because the God I serve is a good God. He's a great God and he's worthy to be praised. I pray for the kingdom to come. I pray that his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And I come to church today to praise God. I come to church today to worship my God, despite what you may think. But I don't come because I want to be seen today, but I come because God's been good to me. And when I come into the house of the Lord and I think about how God's been good to me, I've got to open up my mouth and tell God, thank you for all that you've done for me. But I also want to thank you for what you're going to do for me. Come on now. How many know that God's not through with you yet? You ain't seen nothing yet. If you think life is good now, you ain't seen nothing yet. There's more in store for you. God has greater things for you. But you've got to hang in there. You've got to hold on until your change comes, because your change is on the way. Come on, give your neighbor a high five and say, neighbor, I just feel something. I feel something deep down in my spirit. I feel like my change is coming. I've been going through long enough, but I feel like my change is coming. Sometimes up, sometimes down, almost level to the ground. But today, as I sit here, as I stand here, I feel like my help is on the way. My change is coming. If you believe that today, come on, shake somebody's hand like you're gonna shake it off and say, neighbor, I feel like a change is coming on. Now look now, if you had to get up and find somebody hand to shake, because the person sitting next to you, they won't shake your hand. Maybe they don't need what you need. But if you know that you know, that you know that you know, that you need a blessing from your God, find yourself a neighbor. Shake that hand like you're gonna shake it off and say, neighbor, I feel my help is coming. But not only that, I have to learn how to forgive. Understand today that unless you forgive, God won't open doors for you. The Bible says that as much as Job had gone through, God decided, now I'm going to bless Job, because now Job, he has forgiven those who blessed
people who did something against him. And because he forgave his friends, God said, now I'm going to give you double for your trouble. Anybody need double today? You just don't want a one portion, but you want a double portion. You've got to learn how to forgive. You've got to make up in your mind, I ain't gonna let nobody stop me from getting my blessing from my God. Go ahead and talk about me, I'm gonna forgive you. Go ahead and hate on me, I'm gonna forgive you. Go ahead and scandalize my name, I'm gonna forgive you. Go ahead and don't treat me right, I'm still gonna forgive you. Because when I forgive you, God will open up the windows of heaven and pour me out a blessing. So I ain't gonna let nobody stop me from forgiving you. God, I want to thank you today. But not only is God a forgiving God, but God forgives us so much that he then treats us like we never did it. Isn't that a great thing? You know, when you do stuff to people, they never forget it. But I'm so glad today that not only do I serve a forgiving God, but he's able to forget God. And I'm glad today that in all the bad stuff I've done in my life, he not only forgave me, but he forgot what I did. Come on, tap your neighbor and say, neighbor, aren't you glad God forgot about your mess? Oh, come on, don't play with me now. How many know that God brought you out of some mess in your life? How many know today that God brought you out of some stinky stuff in your life, and he turned you around and he blessed you anyway? I'm convinced that some people don't like you because they know you're dirt, and they don't understand why God still blesses you. But I've got news for them. You can know all of my dirt, but I serve a God who loves me. I serve a God who cares about me. I serve a God who's able to bless me anyhow. Some of my praise is an anyhow praise. Lord, I haven't been the best, but I'm going to praise you anyhow. Didn't dot every I or cross every T, but God, I thank you anyhow. I haven't always done all that I should do, but God, you bless me anyhow. I came to give God an anyhow praise. Come on, shake your neighbor's hand like you're gonna shake it off, and say, neighbor, come on and praise God anyhow. I know you don't feel like it, but come on and open up your mouth and give God praise anyhow. I dare you to praise God. I dare you to open up your mouth, because I know that when praises go up, blessings come down. Come on, open up your mouth and praise the God of our salvation. Well, give me about 5 more minutes, but I'm glad today that I serve a God that hears and he answers prayer. Aren't you glad about that? That God hears and he answers prayer. He is a prayer answering God. Oh yes, he is. He will answer your prayer while you are a citizen, a tax-paying citizen of the United States of America. If you got in trouble, you can call the White House all you want to, and try to get the president all you want to. to. The president won't be able to help you with your problem. As a taxpaying citizen of the state of North Carolina, if you get in trouble and you call the governor, the governor might not even return your call, and he won't be able to help you with your problem. As a taxpaying citizen of the city of Charlotte, the Queen City, you see, you can call the mayor or the city council, and they won't even return your call and won't be able to help you out of your trouble. But you can call on God any day, any hour, any minute. If you call God, his line is never busy. How many know that God will answer your prayer? You've got to learn that when you pray, you've got to wait on God. He may not come when you want to, but he knows. How many know that he's right on time? How many know he's an on-time God? Yes, he is. The Bible says the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. It's good to know today. I can cast all of my cares upon him, for he careth for me. When you pray, you gotta have faith. Well, what's faith, y'all? Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not yet seen. You got to have faith. You got to keep the faith. You have to pray and wait. You have to wait and pray. You have to pray and wait some more. Then you have to wait and pray some more. And if you keep on hanging on in there, how many know that God will answer your prayer? But not only do you have to wait on God, you have to have expectation that God's going to do what you need God to do. But not only that, you've got to be persistent. You've got to keep knocking on that door, believing that God is able to answer your prayer. Well, I like those nature shows. Are y'all gonna pray with me? I like those nature shows. And one day I saw with this honey badger, he was hungry, and he was so hungry that he saw a beehive. Now you know, you don't mess with no bees in no beehive, but this honey badger was so hungry that he decided to stick his face right in the beehive. And I'm looking at it now, and I say to myself, that animal must be crazy. Those bees gonna tear him up. And the thing that I learned from it was that honey badger stuck his head in that beehive, because what was in the beehive was worth going through all of the trouble. Y'all not hearing me? The benefit was greater than what he had to go through. And I come to tell somebody today, with all you've been through, it's going to be more benefit at the end of it when God brings you out. Come on, shake somebody's hand like you're going to shake it off and say, neighbor, hang in there. I know it hurts right now. I know you're going through right now. But when God blesses you, it's going to be worth all that you had to go through. Well, let me get to my text, because I know y'all tired of me, but I just feel like preaching today. I just feel feel something deep down on the inside of me today. The Bible tells us that there was a man named Bartimaeus, a son of Timaeus, and he was a blind man. Now, I don't know how long he had been blind, but the Bible just tells us he was a blind man. The Bible says that one day there was a commotion going on, and I imagine that Bartimaeus could feel something going on. And when he could feel the commotion going on, Bartimaeus asked, what's going on out there? And somebody said, is Jesus of Nazareth passing by? And the Bible says when Bartimaeus heard that it was Jesus, he began to cry out with a loud voice, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And the Bible said, as much as he cried out, the people around him said, you need to hush up and stop all of that noise. Well, I asked the question, why were they so quiet? And the answer is, they didn't need anything from the Lord. But how many know that when you need something from God and you need it bad enough, you don't care how loud you get. You just cry out, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. The Bible said they tried to shut him up, but the more they tried to keep him quiet, he cried out the more. And some of y'all, you can't let your neighbor intimidate you. If they don't want to praise him, let them not praise him. Maybe they don't need what you need, but when you know God's got what you want, when you know God's got what you need, you ought to come in here and open up your mouth and shout, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy upon me. The Bible said that he kept crying out, and the Bible lets us know that finally, as he cried out, Jesus stopped and heard his cry. Come on, give your neighbor a high five and say, neighbor, God's just stopped and he's listening to your prayer. You ought to tell God thank you. You ought to give God glory. You've been praying a long time. You've been trusting God a long time. But today is your day. And I come to tell you today, if at first you don't succeed, try again. Maybe God didn't answer the first time, or maybe God didn't answer the second time. But how many know that today is your day? You're not hearing me. If you know that you know that you know that you know God's got what you need and God can bless your life, tell God thank you. Lift up those hands. Give God glory. How many know he's worthy? He's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. The Bible said that Jesus stopped, asked Bartimaeus, what is it that you want? Bartimaeus said, Lord, I just want to see again. And Jesus said to him, thy faith has healed you. And the Bible said, Bartimaeus got just what he wanted. Aren't you glad today that God is able to supply all your needs? That God is able to give you what you need? That God is able to bless you abundantly above all that you ask or you think? Well, let me tell you this. If you came here to have a pity party, you came to the wrong place. If you came here for woe is me, and that we'll feel sorry for you, you came to the wrong place. But we came to the house of the Lord to have a Holy Ghost party today. I don't know about you, but I came today to cry out to my God. I came today because my God is able. I lift up my hands. I open up my mouth. I tell God thank you, because I know that my blessing is on the way. If you're happy and you know it, say amen. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, jump for joy, because the joy of the Lord is my strength, and the strength of the Lord is my joy. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. Come on, hug your neighbor. Tell him, I'm going to try again. I'm going to try it again. Come on, at least hug three people. Tell them, I'm going to try it again. I'm going to try it again. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Find three more people. Tell them, I'm going to try it again. I was just about ready to give up, but now I'm going to try it again. I'm going to try it again. I'm going back and try it again. Oh yeah, I ain't gonna let the devil defeat me. I'm gonna go back to my God, and I'm gonna try one more time. If there is something you've been praying for and God hasn't answered you yet, He hasn't answered yet, I want you to come to this altar. We're going to pray with you.
The thing that I love about God is that God can give you a new beginning. Can I get a witness here? Anybody know that God can give you a new beginning? He can give you a new beginning. And I want you to not give up. Don't give up. You're too close now. Give up. You too close. You closer than you think you are. So I don't want you to give up. I want you to hang in there a little while longer, because weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Joy does come in the morning. Take the hand of the person standing next to you. And I want you to give that hand a little squeeze. Squeeze some strength into that hand. That hand that you're holding came in weak today. Didn't know how they were going to make it. But squeeze some strength into that hand right now. In the name of Jesus. God, thank you. Thank you for more strength. Felt like giving up. Felt like turning around. But God, I just want to thank you today for strength for the journey. Thank you that you're easing my journey as we stand here right now. The way, God, you're making a way out of no way. In the name of Jesus. God, we just want to thank you in advance because everything's going to be all right. Because we believe what your word says. Your word says, and we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them that are the called according to your purpose. So God, we just want to thank you today. If there is healing needed at this altar, God, heal right now. Touch right now in the name of Jesus and bring healing, emotional healing, spiritual healing today. And God, we just want to thank you. Because we feel like we can hold on now. We feel like we can make it a little while longer. What the devil meant for our evil, God, you have the power to turn it into good. So God, thank you for that. Thank you for that. Now, Lord, we thank you that you are our Father, our Daddy. And you know what we need. And we believe it's already done in the name of Jesus. We believe it's already done in the name of Jesus. And if it's not here, it just means that the time wasn't right. But God, we know that the clock is ticking. And when the time is right, you're going to give us just what we need. I touch and agree with the hand that I'm holding. I give that hand a little squeeze and I thank you right now that it's already done. In Jesus' name, bless our families. Bless our children. Bless our children's children. Bless our church family today, God. In Jesus' name, we ask it all. Amen. And amen. And amen. Hug your neighbor. Tell them, try it again. Try it again. Try it again. Just try.